Well, we're looking at mostly dry conditions today, which will be nice after yesterday's isolated thunderstorms. You probably already noticed it's a bit cooler out there and not as muggy. The cold front that wanted to come through stalled out overhead and gave us all that unsettled weather yesterday, finally pushed through, and it's cleared out some things. So not quite as muggy or warm today, which is nice. A couple of isolated thunderstorms in the mountains today and a couple more as we go throughout the day tomorrow. I'll take you through that here in just a second. Isaias is now moving across Washington and continues to move even farther north away from us, but had quite an impact on our coast. 4.5-foot storm surge in Myrtle Beach was recorded. Also at Spring Made Pier, it's the third highest water level ever recorded. It was Hurricane Hugo and Matthew were the other two. So very big deal there. And then in North Carolina, we had 97 mile per hour wind gusts at Frying Pan Tower in North Carolina. That was right around the time Isaias made landfall at 85 miles an hour. So a pretty strong Category 1 hurricane when it made landfall just after 11 o'clock last night. Now you can see earlier today, it was in North Carolina, crossed over into the Virginia border, and now it's racing through Washington, still holding together at 70 miles an hour. So it's still a strong tropical storm, but I tell you, this thing is moving. It's booking it. 35 miles an hour doesn't seem like a lot, but it's covering a lot of territory in a short amount of time. Expected to hold together as a tropical storm almost until it gets to Canada. Right now showing it weakening back to an area of low pressure by the time it does arrive there, but pretty impressive nonetheless. We've got a dry start to the day today, which is nice. We've got a few clouds out there, some of us seeing some sun. As we go into late this afternoon, we'll see a couple of thunderstorms squeeze out across mainly in the mountains. One or two showers might develop here in the upstate, but I say again, most of us stay dry. As we go throughout the day tomorrow, it'll be more like business as usual with a dry start to the day. And then those afternoon thunderstorms bubble up in the mountains and a couple of those spread across the upstate. It's going to take until Thursday till we get back to those scattered showers across the area. Some of these could be a little bit heavy at times, but you could see very widespread. Certainly not a washout, though. That is the good news. Highs today, low to mid 80s across the upstate. We'll be back in the 90s for the next couple of days. That heat and humidity will help spark some of those afternoon thunderstorms. As we head into the weekend, we're looking at dry starts to the day, but very isolated chances for rain for the afternoons. And again, most of that will be in the mountains, but still pretty isolated. Look at your highs in the mountains today. Not bad at all. Low 80s feels almost like fall, which is just over 40 days away.